Till now we have covered data handling part 1. From today onwards we are going to start data handling part 2 as per CBSE syllabus. In today's lecture we will cover descriptive statistics, that is how to find maximum, minimum, how to find sum and how to count number of rows or columns based on a data frame or a series. Descriptive statistics with pandas. Python pandas has the ability to manipulate some statistical data and calculate results of various statistical operations. Okay, let us start again. So Python pandas has the ability to manipulate some statistical data. You might have done chapter statistics in class 10th, in which we calculate mean, mode, median, etc. So all this is statistics. So it is used to calculate results of various statistical operations. It has a widely used data science library and offers innumerable useful statistical and aggregate functions. These aggregate functions you have already done in MySQL, like sum, max, min, count, etc. Statistical methods help in understanding and analyzing behavior of data. So we have a term here, that is data aggregation. So aggregation is the process of turning the values of a data set, means any table or tabular form of data, into one single value. For example, count, sum, min, max, median, quartile, etc. These aggregations are also known as descriptive statistics, such as to find out highest marks or to count number of students participating in an exam, etc. Let us see how we can do all these things. First of all, we will take an example. Based on this example, we will do all the aggregations. So for implementing aggregate functions, let us create a data frame as given below. You can note it down later on. I will provide PDF. Until unless you do practical, you will not understand all these things. You must do practicals of these things. Import pandas as PD, import numpy as NP. Data is equal to name, and there are 12 names here. Age, 12 ages, marks. So this is just a tabular form. And we have created marks df data frame. By marks df is equal to pd dot data frame data. See, if you print marks df, this is your output. So based on this data, we will do all the calculations. So you can say this will be a reference data frame to understand this chapter. Okay, next. Now there are some important aggregate and statistical functions. Let us see what are these. These are in your syllabus. Count, count function. It is used to count number of non-null values. It means number of those values which do not contain NaN values or none, etc. Sum, it is used to find out sum of values. Mean or average, it is used to find out mean of values. Median, mode, standard deviation, minimum, maximum. We will see all these one by one. Okay. So first is max. We have taken easier functions first. The first is max. Very simple. Max is used to find maximum value from a given set of values or columns of a data frame or a series. It means all these functions can also be applied on a series. That is why we are used this term series here. So what is the syntax? Df, then within square brackets we write column name dot max. See this example. Display maximum value from all columns of marks df. This is your marks df. This is your column marks. This is your column age and column name. Now, what is the question? We have to find out maximum value from all these columns. If manually we see maximum value in marks, we have this 89 here. This is your maximum value. In age, we have 26, 26 two times. So 26 is your maximum value. What about name? Here, Vinay is your maximum value because it starts with V. So we count it as from A to Z. So Z is the largest one. Okay, let us see how to do this. Marks df dot max. We simply write like this. Marks df dot max. So it will display maximum value, but from all the columns, not from a single column. See, output of name is Vinay. Output of age, maximum value from the column age is 26. Maximum value from marks is 89. Next. One more example. Now to get maximum value of a particular column, for example, age. Not from all the columns. So we have to provide this name also. So we will write marks df age within square brackets, then dot max. Your answer will be 26. Compare this with this one, marks df. Here there is no column name, and here we have provided a column name in square brackets. So your 26, that is age 26, is the highest one. It is displayed. Next, one more example to get maximum value of the column name. So separately also you can do max, marks df, then provide name dot max. So from this name column, the highest value will be displayed. This is your name column, and your highest value is starting with V, that is Vinay. So your answer is Vinay. Second function, min function, very similar. I will not go into details. So min is used to find minimum value from a given set of values or columns of data frame or a series. Same syntax, see question, display minimum value from all the columns. So just replace max with min, rest is same. So your name is Ajay, it started with A. Then age is 22, minimum age, you can see here it is 22. Yes, one more is there, 22. And minimum marks, if you compare all these, minimum marks is this one, 31. So I think output is clear. Next. To get the minimum value of the column age, means if you want to provide a name of column, just write name in square brackets along with name of data frame. So marks df and within square brackets age dot min. Your answer is 22. Next, to get the minimum value of the column name, marks df name dot min Ajay. Very simple. Now third one is sum. You know, sum is used to find out total of all the values in a particular column. See this example, display total of column marks. It means you want to find out total of all these values. No need of using calculator. So what you have to do, just write marks df and provide the name of column dot sum. So you can see 803 is your answer. You can check it manually also later on. It will be 803. You can also use print command. We are not using print command, but we can use it in a program. Answer will be same, 803. Next. So there is a note for you. Sum function skips the missing values by default. It means if there is a missing value, we have already discussed what are missing values. You need to revise that topic also. So sum skips the missing values by default. It means it never adds missing values. Obviously, if some value is missing, how can we add it? But what are missing values? Can anybody tell me? How can we represent missing values?
By using NaN.
Very good, very good. Okay, very good. So if we use NaN somewhere, that value will not be added up. But here, if you see marks and age, no NaN value is there. You will see NaN value in the next screen. However, we can define that by passing a skip NA argument. So this is an argument, skip NA, with either true or false value. See example first, marks df within square brackets marks dot sum. Here we have provided skip NA is equal to true. It means skip the NaN values, skip the missing values, skip NA. Very simple. By default also, skip NA is true. It means if you do not provide skip NA is equal to true, then also skip NA becomes true by default. It means NaN values will be skipped every time. But what will happen if we do not want to skip NaN values? It means if I write skip NA is equal to false, what will happen? Okay, let us see. So I think this is clear. See, this is the syntax. Green box, dekhiye, this is your syntax. You must know how to write syntax theoretically. Exam mein kai baar aa sakta hai. So df then square brackets column name dot sum skip NA is equal to true or false. Next. So what I have done, I have created this data frame again by deliberately using NaN value. I have included only one NaN value. NaN value uses NumPy library, that is why we have imported this NumPy here. Earlier there was no use. So the same data is there, but here instead of last marks, I have written np.na in small letters, not capitals. So with this, if you display marks df, this will be your output. See, at the last, there is NaN value, not a number. NaN means missing value. Now, if you find out sum of marks, what will happen? This NaN value will be skipped. Only these values will get added up. See examples one by one. marks df marks dot sum skip na is equal to true. No need to write skip na is equal to true. Why? Because it is by default. True is by default. But still you can write. So your answer is 726.0. See second statement. Here I have not written skip na. So marks df marks dot sum directly. Again 726.0. Same answer. It means skip na is equal to true is by default. Now what will happen if we use false? Marks df marks dot sum skip na is equal to false. It will give nan missing value, nan value, not a number. Nan ka matlab not a number. Instead of 726, now it is giving nan. Why? Any guesses? No answer. Okay. Now, whenever we try to add, because by writing skip na is equal to false, what are we trying? We are trying to add missing value. A missing value hai, usko add to kar hi nahi sakte. Fir bhi hum try kar rahe hain usko add karna. To missing value hai aayegi na. Answer will be missing value. We are trying to add this np.nan. Hum isko add karne ki koshish kar rahe hain. By writing skip n is equal to false. Ki humne ye bola ki skip mat karo. Then all these when added up with nan, your answer will be nan. Very simple. Isko prove karne ke liye niche maine ek example likha hai. See this example. If you write 10 plus 5, your answer is 15. But if you write 10 plus nan value, np.nan, your answer is nan. So nan ke saath kuch bhi aap add karo, answer nan hi aata hai. So I think this is clear. Aisi koi situation aayegi nahi waise kabhi ki hame nan value bhi add karne pade. Okay, next. Okay, this is your last topic, count. There are 2-3 slides based on this. Thoda dhyan se dekhna. Okay, count. It is used to get the number of values present in a column of a data frame or series. Count means counting. Count karke batana kitne hai. That's it. So now it counts all the non-NAN entries for each row or column. Now there are some different type of values. For example, none. None is also a value. NAN is also a value. All these none, NAN, etc. values. X kahan se aaya? It should be C. Etc. values are considered NA in pandas. NA means not available or missing values. अगर कहीं none लिखा है वो भी missing values, अगर कहीं nan np.nan लिखा है वो भी missing values मानी जाएंगी. तो count missing values को छोड़कर counting करेगा. It counts all the non-nan entries. Okay. Syntax, similar syntax, df then within square brackets right column name dot count x is equal to 0 or x is equal to 1. Okay, let us see what does it mean. X is equal to 0 ya fir x is equal to index, aise bhi likh sakte hain. Ek example aaya tha last time, we have written x is equal to index also. It means count function is performed for each column. Ye aapko dhyan rakhna hai. एक्सेस इज इक्वल टू जीरो लिखा है तो काउंट फंक्शन कॉलम वाइज काम करेगा, काउंटिंग करेगा. कुछ नहीं मेंशन करोगे, इफ यू डू नॉट मेंशन एक्सेस देन बाय डिफॉल्ट एक्सेस विल बी टेकन एज जीरो. इट मींस बाय डिफॉल्ट कॉलम वाइज ही काउंटिंग होगी. बट इफ यू राइट एक्सेस इज इक्वल टू 1 या फिर एक्सेस इज इक्वल टू रोज, काउंटिंग इज डन बेस्ड ऑन ईच रो नॉट कॉलम. let us see example. Example, to get the total number of entries of the column name. So how many entries are there in the column name? You know there is no NN value and the last is 11 starting from 0, so it is 12. Let us see. Marks df name dot count, answer is 12. It does counting, so it is counting elements of this column 1, 2, 3. It goes like this. Second example, to get the total number of entries of the column marks, marks df, then instead of name you write marks dot count, answer is 11. Now why answer is 11? See here, we have one NaN value, this is not counted. The total rows were 12 and one is NaN value, so answer should be 11. So I think this is clear. Okay, next example, to get the total number of elements in each column. It means here we are not providing name of the column. So if you write directly marks df dot count access is equal to 0, then it will do counting for all the columns, not rows. Do not get confused. All the columns. Let us see. Name, there are 12 entries, so name is equal to 12. There are 12 entries in age, so age is equal to 12 and marks is equal to 11 because there is one NaN value jo count nahi hoti. Okay, if you do not write access is equal to 0 like this, same output will be there. It means by default access is always 0. Yani ki agar aap kuch bhi provide nahi karte hain, yahan access nahi batate hain, jaise do access hote hain, access 0 aur 1, access x axis y axis, नहीं प्रोवाइड करेंगे तो बाय डिफॉल्ट ये कॉलम वाइज काम करेगा. ओके, लेट अस मूव टू द नेक्स्ट वन. टू गेट द टोटल नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन ईच रो, पहले क्या था, सी ये पहले था कॉलम, नाउ दिस वन इज रो. हर एक रो में कितने एलिमेंट्स हैं? तो वैसे तो आपको दिख रहा है हर एक रो में, जीरोथ रो में 1, 2, 3, there are three column, sorry, three elements. Ajay, 2685. In row number 1, yani ki second row, isme bhi 1, 2, 3, there are three elements. See the last one, 11th row. Here we have 1 and 2, only two elements. Ye count nahi hoga, NaN value will not be counted. Now see output. Marks df dot count access is equal to 2. So 0, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3. That means 0th row mein 3 element hai, first row mein 3 element, aise hi 11th row mein 2 elements. Okay, next. तो आज के लिए बस इतना ही था. वी हैव कवर्ड मैक्स मिन काउंट एंड सम. टुमारो वी विल कवर मीन मोड मीडियन. तो धीरे धीरे कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी थोड़ी सी बढ़ती जाएगी. यू नीड टू डू प्रैक्टिस. कंप्यूटर पर प्रैक्टिस करिए, लैपटॉप पर प्रैक्टिस करिए. एंड इफ यू डू नॉट हैव लैपटॉप, यू कैन इंस्टॉल इन ऑन एंड्रॉइड ऑल्सो. मोबाइल में भी चलता है, पहले भी बता चुके हैं. You can take help of others. So we have still time left. Do you want to ask something? किसी को कुछ पूछना है? इफ यू वांट टू आस्क
सर ये रो वाला एक बार और बताना
कौन सा वाला
लास्ट वाला लास्ट जो अभी हुआ था वही वाला
अच्छा ठीक है दिस वन यही
यस
ओके
यस सर
ओके आई एम रिपीटिंग दिस See, our question is to get the total number of elements in each row. हर एक रो में कितने एलिमेंट्स हैं? अब जो रोज होती हैं वो हॉरिजॉन्टल होती हैं. This is your first row, जिसका इंडेक्स है जीरो, रो नंबर वन. This is your second row, जिसका इंडेक्स है वन. ऐसे करके all these are rows. Question ये नहीं है how many rows are there. ध्यान रखना. Question है how many elements in each row you have to display. तो जीरो थ्रो में कितने एलिमेंट्स हैं? अजय 26 एंड 85.0 यानी कि तीन एलिमेंट. सो योर आंसर इज 0, 3. इट मींस इन रो नंबर 0 वी हैव 3 एलिमेंट्स. सिमिलरली इन रो नंबर 1 वी हैव 3 एलिमेंट्स. In row number 2 also we have 3 elements, but in row number 11 we have 2 elements. Yahan dekhiye, we have only 2 elements in row number 11, Rinku and 24. NN to count nahi hoga, bataya tha. So I think this is clear.
Yes sir.
Okay, any other doubt?
No sir.